How long has it been, or has it ever happened to you, that someone whom you wouldn't have expected called you on the phone just to ask how you are? How you doing? Been thinking about you. In fact, I've been praying for you. Is there anything I can do? Hi, I'm Bill Pearce, and this is Nightsounds. In fact, along that line tonight, I was thinking about the pastor of your church, if you happen to have one. How long has it been, or has it ever happened, that you've called him to say, "Hey, pastor, I really appreciate you and what you're doing. I want you to know that I was thinking about you, and I'm praying for you." I did that a couple of minutes before coming into the studio tonight. I'll tell you about it as we move ahead. Tonight's program, The Invisible Servant, speaking about that very important person in our lives, our pastor. And so many times, pastors are invisible in their ministry. We may only see them once a week or perhaps twice for church on Sunday or maybe a prayer meeting or run into them somewhere along the week. And as we focus on the pastor, whomever he or she may be, appointed by God as an under-shepherd for a congregation of however many, what a tremendous responsibility, and how they come to those places in their lives and our lives when we wonder, and they wonder, whether what they are doing is working. So tonight's program is really an encouragement for the pastor. And I hope there are many pastors listening right now, and many parishioners or congregation members or just plain friends or concerned Christians. We all need encouragement, don't we? And more than you would ever imagine, the pastor needs to know that he or she has a support system behind them, standing with them in prayer and in love. And if you stay with us for the entire half hour tonight, I think you might be surprised at some of the statistics we come up with concerning your pastor. In our musical agenda, Tom Netherton to open, focusing on that one on whom we depend, whether we're in the congregation or as the pastor here. Is our focus.
When the hope you had has disappeared, and you've lost the will to try, and you think your ship has just come in, but it keeps on passing by. When you've almost gained the victory, and you've left the rest behind, and the marathon has slowed its pace as you reach the finish line. And you're round the final corner, but you fall. Depend on me.
You can depend on
me. Depend on me.
You can depend upon
me. Depend on me. When the world has let you down, depend on me. When you feel you're losing ground, depend on me. When your love has been denied, when you've lost your earthly pride, you can depend on me. When your life is filled with emptiness, and your friends have said goodbye, and the hill becomes a mountain as your troubles multiply. When your trials get too much to bear, and you're standing all alone, and the feeling way down deep inside is the worst you've ever known, and you need someone to count on, but no one's there. Depend on me. on me. When you feel you're losing ground, depend on me. When your love has been denied, when you've lost your earthly pride, you can depend on me.
Netherton, the song Depend on Me. And our program tonight is centering on the pastor. A pastor of the church that you might attend, or any pastor you might know. A very special calling, to say the least. And in our program tonight, I noticed an article in a recent edition of Discipleship Journal by Wes Roberts. Here's a man whose ministry it is to consult with and counsel Christian leaders worldwide. What a tremendous kind of an outreach. We don't hear of that very much anymore, but how needed it is. He said, among other things, if you could sit with us as the telephones ring each day in our offices and listen in on the conversations, you would probably weep, most likely be startled, and often wonder what's happening to our Christian leaders today, even to the very best of them. And to get a truly accurate picture, you'd really need to take at least 30 days to live night and day with your pastor, or your missionary friend, or that parachurch worker you have an interest in. 30 days? Pretty scary project, isn't it? And most of us couldn't do that. But it might interest you to know, the pastor, even one who's wise with his schedule, is on duty 27 hours a day, 39 days a month, 412 days a year. The fact is, our pastors need our loving support, or their chances of getting burned out or even failing are great. And as we look in the scriptures tonight, there's an urgency for us to honor and care for our pastors. Let's take a look at 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 12. And now, friends, we ask you to honor those leaders who work so hard for you, who've been given the responsibility of urging and guiding you along in your obedience. Overwhelm them with appreciation and love. Another portion of scripture from Hebrews chapter 13, verse 7. Appreciate your pastoral leaders who gave you the word of God. Take a good look at the way they live and let their faithfulness instruct you as well as their truthfulness. Tonight, as we're concentrating for a moment or two on the pastor, with our program titled The Invisible Servant, I use the word invisible because so much of what he or she does is not seen by us. Again, maybe we see them in action on a given Sunday morning or throughout the day, all the way to the end of Sunday night, or a prayer meeting on Wednesday. But that's the tip of the iceberg. One who knows the pastor's schedule said, "He teaches, though he must solicit his own classes. He heals, though without pills or knife. He's sometimes a lawyer, even a social worker, something of an editor, a bit of a philosopher and entertainer, a salesman, a decorative piece for public functions, and he's supposed to be a scholar. He visits the sick, marries people, buries the dead, labors to console those who sorrow, and to admonish those who sin, and tries to stay sweet when chided for not doing his duty. He plans programs, appoints committees when he can get them, spends considerable time in keeping people out of each other's hair. Between times, he prepares a sermon and preaches it to those who don't happen to have any other engagement. Then on Monday, he smiles when some jovial guy roars, 'What a job, one day a week.' Some time ago, we had the privilege of doing a program about the pastor's wife. Now there is another picture of a person we perhaps don't know. Maybe we'll get into that again. I realize that there are many other kinds of Christian workers in God's vineyard. But tonight, I suppose the one who is closest to us would be the pastor in our spiritual walk. And I'm quoting to some extent Wes Roberts, a man who's given his life to the ministry of consulting and counseling Christian leaders. And the scripture is clear that you and I are to even overwhelm our pastors with love and appreciation. A few minutes ago, I mentioned I called a local pastor whom I know and with whom I have lunch now and then, and he counsels me and we listen to each other. I called his church and got a secretary on the line. And she said, "The pastor is not in right now." I said, "Well, will you give him a message for me?" And she said, "Yes." I said, "Will you tell him that I'm in the Lord's work too?" And I gave her my name. "And would you let him know that I love and appreciate him and that I'm praying for him continually?" And I heard nothing on the other end of the line. And she said, "Is that it?" I said, "That's it, and hopefully that's a lot." I think she was sort of startled to hear a message like that. But why should she be? Why should we be? To have someone call you and tell you that they love you and appreciate you. Now, I'm talking about love in a certain sense, not romantic love, but deep appreciation, a love for the Lord and His working through that other person. We take so much for granted. But Scripture's clear. You and I are to overwhelm our pastoral staff with love and appreciation. Why? To encourage them to live faithful and truthful lives. I'll never forget the time when Nightsounds was going through a very deep and dark moment in its ministry. We moved to different quarters in the town in which we live, and this pastor, whom I mentioned a moment ago, brought his entire staff, and he's pastor of the largest church in the area. The staff represented about 15 or 18 people, including his wife, who runs the Christian school, and the entire group of them surrounded the studio, wall to wall and all the way around. We held hands, and they prayed for Nightsounds. I've never had that happen before. So, in a sense, this is not political. It's not you do me a favor, I do you a favor, at all. There's no factor like that present. But it just occurred to me tonight, as I was preparing for this program, that hey, I want to do this. And I want to tell my audience of Night Sounds to encourage their Christian leadership as well. Wes Roberts, whom we're quoting tonight, who has the ministry of consulting, consoling, and counseling Christian leaders worldwide, had a few suggestions that might be well for any and all of us to follow. One of the things he said that's almost taken for granted, but maybe we forget it, is to give time. Tell your pastor you've rearranged your personal schedule. You have 6 free hours per month to give him in 2 3-hour blocks. Now, this may be unrealistic. If not that, just call the office and ask him out to lunch. But if you gave him the time to help with the life of the church, just an encouragement, or as you can in other ways, what a tremendous gesture. Give him a call. With sensitivity to his schedule, just a spontaneous bit of encouragement to see how it's doing. Limit your call to 5 minutes or less, focusing on your care and concern. And don't say, now that I have you on the line, let me unload something that's been on my heart. Let's not do that to him, okay? And don't stand for gossip. Whenever you hear people criticize your pastor, encourage them to go directly to him with any comments. Wes Roberts said, my office files contain a folder with handwritten notes, even some printed email messages that I've kept to read on down days when I've wondered if I'm fit to serve within the kingdom of God. How about making a practice of sending your pastor a note of appreciation for something that you've caught him doing very well? This might surprise him. Recognize his gifts. Speak the word of God into his life. Find a particular Bible verse that you've been sitting on for a while and just share it with him. Incidentally, we've heard, because of these difficult days in which we live, that pastors are faced with problems that were not encountered with pastoral staffs, say, 10 to 15 to 25 years ago. And in a few moments, I'd like to give you some reasons why pastors burn out. And they're doing it by the droves. We need each other. We need to depend on someone. The pastor is the under-shepherd. We need to know that we're a network of power in prayer against the enemy of the soul who is out to do us all in. But let's remind each other, sort of like Weight Watchers, you know. If somebody gets into a fix or stands in front of the refrigerator and he or she is 40 to 50 pounds overweight, they feel the urge. They're going down fast. The refrigerator doesn't have a lock on it. And they pick up the phone and say, help. This is even more urgent than that. And let's not forget to pray. How we need the Lord. How we need each other to link arms and hearts together. Our ministry, called Night Sounds, our support system staff and volunteers here, we couldn't exist without them. We don't take them for granted. I don't take you for granted. You are part of a fantastic network as you stand with us in prayer, as we reach out together to a hurting world, a desperate world for Jesus Christ. And as the choir sings open vowel sounds with the orchestra right now, many of you recognize the tune. Pray it with us. Savior, like a shepherd, lead us. We need your care so much. Thank you. And the verse ends, "Blessed Jesus, you have loved us, love us still." But he can love us through each other, too. This is Night Sounds. I'm Bill Pearce with you and Thurlow Spur in the group, singing and playing in the background that familiar song of prayer, "Savior, like a shepherd, lead us." Let's remember that the Lord is our shepherd, but the under-shepherd, your pastor, needs encouragement, needs your love. We need to hold on to each other before God until Jesus comes to take us all home. Night Sounds continuing in our program tonight, subtitled "The Invisible Servant, Your Pastor." Taking just a moment's break, may I remind you that Night Sounds continues after we go off the air through the surfaces of our series on various subjects and topics, some stress areas, situations we face day by day, one of which is relationships. We have a series of 8 programs on this subject to answer the requests of many listeners. If we can send a catalog on the very important adjacent ministries of Night Sounds, our mailing address is Box 29, Wheaton, Illinois, 60189. A few moments ago, as I mentioned, reasons why pastors burn out. Some of them we would never consider. But statistically, 90% work more than 46 hours per week, and often more than 60. 90% of pastors felt they were not adequately trained to cope with the ministry demands placed upon them. 80% believe that pastoral ministry is affecting their families negatively. 75% have reported a significant crisis due to stress at least once every 5 years by their ministry. 70% do not have someone they could consider a close friend. 70% have a lower self-image after they've pastored than when they started. 50% of pastors felt unable to meet the needs of the job. 40% reported a serious conflict with a parishioner at least once a month. 37% have been involved in inappropriate sexual behavior with someone in the church. 33% say being in ministry is clearly a hazard to my family. This is a survey of pastors by the Fuller Institute of Church Growth. And tonight's program, The Invisible Servant. And I think most of us begin to realize how our church leaders need our prayers. You may have questions regarding yours. Maybe you think yours isn't in that particular category we've mentioned. But let's not forget that they serve the Lord God out of a call and a commission. And most of them stay faithfully by their posts. Come rain or high water or anything else. Lord God, as we come to the point of need in our lives, we all desperately need you. And may we be faithful in upholding our pastors as they serve you without fail. Bind us together, Lord God, in your love, we pray. How we need you. How we need each other. Come near us. Bless that man, that woman, as they stand in the pulpit, as they get their hands dirty, serving you through the ministry that you've called them to. May we all cooperate. In the name of the one who called us, through the power of the Holy Spirit, on the authority of your everlasting word. Amen. We need to be open to the Holy Spirit's leading for just how creative we can be to help our pastor. Let's stretch ourselves a bit and see what happens as they can relax and come alive and come forward in their unique calling. Ministers of the gospel of Jesus Christ, what a tremendous mission field. What an awesome task. Let's be with them. One in the Lord, okay? Thank you so much for joining us tonight. Lord willing, we'll see each other on the program Nightsounds or in the air. It'll be better yet. Until we meet, God bless you and good night.